Hey, so one of the things that I found a little confusing when I was first starting out with Ableton is the quantization menu up here on the left side of the screen. So I thought I'd do a little tutorial today showing you how it works and maybe clear up some of the confusion that you might have as well. So let's get right to it. So before we even start, I'm just gonna press Command Zero to deactivate quantization, right? So that we can actually see what that implies and understand why we need quantization. So when we talk about quantization here, we mean when you launch stuff, be it clips or scenes, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead and launch a couple scenes at random, and let's hear what that sounds like. So here's one, here's another one. Right? So as you could probably notice, it didn't feel like it was just a nice song that was flowing right. There was this jump in tempo almost. That is precisely why we need quantization. I'm just gonna go ahead and set this to maybe 2 bars. So let's do the same thing and let's hear the difference. Okay, I'm gonna launch the next one. It flashes. And then Ableton launches it perfectly in sync, right? Now it felt like a song, like there were no interruptions, no weird jumps and stuff like that. So how does it work though, right? Let me show that to you. So I have some clips here, as you can see. Let me select this blue one because it's long enough and it's empty. So we have set our quantization value to 2 bars. So I'm just gonna highlight 2 bars here. And what that means is that within those 2 bars that we just highlighted, at any time, we can launch a new clip or scene, and Ableton is gonna wait for that 2-bar period to be over, and then it's gonna perform the action that we just told it to do, and it's gonna be perfectly in sync. So let me show that to you by just launching the same clip over and over again. So I'm gonna launch it, and then I'm gonna launch it again, and watch what happens. Cursor moves, I launch it again. Maybe that was a little too quick. Let me set this to 4 bars then, so we have more time. So I'm gonna highlight 4 bars this time. I'm gonna do the same experiment. So I'm gonna launch a clip, launch it again, and notice how now there is a second cursor down here, but the first one is still waiting for the 4-bar window to be over, and then it starts. And the same would happen if I were to launch a separate clip, so let's do that as well. I'm launching the first one, then I'm launching the second one. As you can see, there is a cursor there, but it's not starting yet. It's waiting for the first one to be over. And then it launches the second one. So what we're telling Ableton by setting the quantization value to 4 is, okay, Ableton, you have a 4-bar window. At any moment within that window, we can launch something new. And then Ableton is gonna wait for that 4-bar window to be over. And then it's gonna perform that action. So at this point, the question is, what should we set it to? And the answer may vary, of course, depending on your playing style. So in general, I would argue that the higher the value, something like 4 bars or maybe even 8 bars, the more time you have, of course, right? Because you have a bigger window to do different things as well, like maybe selecting some other tracks you want to record onto. Maybe you want to turn some knobs, you have some live effects going on, stuff like that. So it's very useful to have a large window in that regard, because again, it gives you time to do all those different things. But it doesn't give you much flexibility, because your minimum waiting time is 8 bars. If you need to switch quicker than that, you can't. So let me show you what I mean. So let's highlight this blue clip again. Now we've set the value to 8 bars, so that would mean all of the clip, right? There's 8 bars here. So I'm gonna launch it, and then I'm gonna launch something else immediately. And that means that we have all of this space right here, all of this time, I should say, at our disposal. We can do different things, select different tracks, move knobs around. And then when the time is right, the next clip will be launched. So that's the advantage. But then again, if we wanted to switch to the next clip before that 8-bar window, say maybe after 4 bars or 2 bars, well, sucks to be you, right? You can't do that. So what works for you is gonna depend on your playing style. Me personally, I found in my experience that the choice here would be either 4 or 2 bars. Let me explain what I mean. Let's use this yellow clip right here, right? As you can see down here, it has 4 bars, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. And each bar has a chord. Now, those are technically arpeggios, I guess, but you know, it's still chords, basically. One chord for each bar. Let's have a listen. First chord, second chord, third chord, and fourth chord. Those 4 different chords, again, 1 chord per bar, represent our smallest musical unit, so to speak, right? That's our building block for our songs. It's a 4-chord sequence. That's the smallest unit, right? And that means that you should probably set the quantization value to 4 bars, because you're never gonna need to switch to a new scene or clip sooner than those 4 bars, right? Because 4 bars is the length of your smallest building block of your song, that 4-chord sequence. Make sense? 4 bars is also relatively long. It's actually the second longest value you could have. So that also gives you plenty of time to perform all different sorts of other things, like I showed you before. So that's a very, very good value, I think. You know, most modern pop music, I would argue, relies on 4-chord sequences, right? So that seems to be the option that would cover the needs of most people. I have found, however, that there are moments, not always, not necessarily most of the time either, but sometimes there are moments where we actually want to split up that smallest musical unit. And it's situations where you maybe want to trick the audience into thinking, okay, now he's going for the verse, but then you interrupt that 4-chord sequence before it's over and you switch to a different section of the song. So, you know, you create that surprise effect. So maybe if I set this to 2, which means that our window is now a 2-bar window, I could launch this, launch another clip, and it would switch to that next clip before all 4 bars of the previous one were over, right? Because we set it to 2 bars. So, you know, I think that's just another cool tool to have at your disposal. Again, as I said, not something you would use all the time necessarily, but when you need it, you're going to be happy that you have enabled it, right? And, you know, 2 bars, 3rd highest possible quantization value. So you still have all the time you need to do some live stuff, right? So I would suggest you use either 2 or 4. Those are probably the best options if you're doing live stuff. Again, if you're just launching clips, then you might even want to consider going lower than 1 bar. You have some options here, like 1/4 note, 1/8 note, stuff like that. Could be very interesting to just create a song just launching clips and using very small quantization values. But again, totally depends on your playing style, but at least now you have the tools you need to determine what would work best for you and figure that out for yourself, right? So yeah, that is pretty much it. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, then please, by all means, write me a comment. I'm happy to help. And if this was helpful to you, then please consider subscribing to the channel. Really helps me out a lot. And that being said, again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.